Daydream Charters goes to the Caribbean again. We flew from Phoenix to Miami, and from Miami, our destination was the U.S. Virgin Islands. We landed in St. Thomas, and our vessel was in Charlotte Amalie here. There's our group arriving. Ann and Mickey from Arizona, Louis from Minnesota, Doralyn came via San Francisco, and we'll meet the rest of the group, but let's take a look at this area where our vessel is docked. Weather is fantastic. This is early December and we were actually hot. Let's take a look at our vessel, a 51-foot motor catamaran. Has a nice flybridge and a very spacious bow. It comes with four cabins and four heads, so it could fit everyone here. I can tell Louis is hot and it was time to head to the pool. Amenities included as usual with the docking fees, and everybody was having a good time and cooling off. But it was time to get some food, hit the Tap and Still, the local joint. From there, we found our way to the vessel, all of us in a timely manner. We had a great day and a fantastic first night. Okay, you ready, Louis?
Yeah.
Okay. We'll have to see where Roy is. All right, there's Roy and Anne. The rest of the crew is ready to go. We are about to depart.
That is
all right. Roy got that line in. Let's see. Louis is gonna handle the next one.
Okay. That's it. Yep.
Good job getting that cow hitch. And here's Roy flemishing the line for us as we depart the marina here at Yacht Haven Grand.
Underway here in St. Thomas. It's Mickey's birthday. Happy birthday! Woohoo! We got Sarah and Captain Sino on the helm, and we got Roy here on the bow. I'm gonna bring this around so we can see our scenery. Departing from St. Thomas, U.S. Virgin Islands, and we're gonna make our way to the bow. That's what we have. Our retirement lady, Dora Lynn, along with Michael. How are you enjoying your trip so far?
Oh my God, it's amazing.
Still want to jump in that water.
All right, soon we will.
Yes, indeed. Soon we will be swimming, as our passage plan is a short one, a little over 7 nautical miles, about an hour and 10 minutes, to the island of Great St. James. Well, we made it to Great St. James and we have a spot for our mooring in mind at Christmas Cove here in U.S. Virgin Islands. This island at one time was worth $3 million. And then, of course, everybody knows about Jeffrey Epstein. He bought it in 2016 for $22 million. And at the time we were there, it was listed for $125 million. I'm sure most of that money is going to go towards the lawsuits. We came here to anchor because there are some really good sandy spots. They have 22 mooring balls and we were lucky to find one. So Anne here and Roy are trying to snag one for us, and we sure did. We were hooked up to that mooring ball. Having settled in, I was wondering, why are we sitting on this boat in this heat with the clothes on? I say we go in the water and cool off, and that's about what I did. Went in the water, and soon enough, everybody followed. Doralyn jumped, followed by Roy, who had no fear going in. Even Sarah was in the water. There she is. We were under the watchful eyes of the Coast Guard.
Coast Guard keeping us safe. Somebody's having beer and having fun over here. What else we got here?
Look at that. The whole gang is here.
Hey, birthday girl. What's going on? Look at Droy is hanging out here.
Everybody's having fun.
Yes, our day has gone by, but not the sunset. It was time to put the dinghy in the water and go on a little sunset ride and check out the boats around us.
Yeah, a little tour of the boats. Yeah. Where's the party?
Lots of flags on that vessel.
Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday to you! Happy birthday, dear! Happy birthday to you!
And we're coming for you, Mickey, to keep singing happy birthday all night long, so be ready for that. In the meantime, my first mate Anne is all decked out looking like Queen Anne, ready for the party.
And you too? Concocting some kind of a fishing lure and a rod and whatever you call it. Oh yeah.
Night fishing off the back of the boat. But where is the fish? The fish is somewhere there.
Look at this one, Mickey.
There he is, he's right below
me. Oh yeah.
I caught a sailfish once. It's about 7-8 foot big.
Wow.
We didn't keep it. It's like I would have had to mount it or something. Yeah. Lived in a little house. No sailfish for me.
Yeah, look at Roy doing his thing. You should not be doing this.
Well, here's someone's got kidding.
Oh, yeah.
That's a long time ago.
Yep.
Let me kiss.
Kiss on the cheek.
Happy birthday, happy birthday to you.
Ken's trying to circle.
Woo! We're going to burn the place down. Everybody likes chocolate cake. Sarah picked it up.
Happy birthday!
Ready and packed.
Okay. Release the mooring ball.
As soon as it's released. Quick.
Are we free? Cast off. Captain Ant.
How we doing there, Roy?
How we doing?
Good.
Okay.
So that way.
You Flemish the lines. No, perfect like that.
And we are officially underway again, passing here by Great St. James Island as we leave it. And the rock that's called Current Rock. Little tight passage, but very doable. It is going to be another windy day today. We expect some swells as we go around St. James and into Pillsbury Sound. But everybody's hanging on and doing well, sitting here at the stern, a little bit more stable than being up top at the flybridge.
How's everybody doing?
Good.
Good.
With the swell subsiding a bit, I have two adventurers that came up top here to check on me, seeing what the captain is doing here.
This is
dangerous! Duro, Lynn, and Roy, I got a brother and a sister here, having a good time looking at Cruiz Bay. But that is not the plan to go there today. Our passage plan calls for us to go to Coral Bay on the eastern side of the island of St. John's. Here's a quick look at the southern part of St. John's as we approach Ram Head and we turn around it to head into Coral Bay. It took an hour and 40 minutes to get here at a speed of a 9.3 knots for about 12 nautical miles. And getting here before noon helps quite a bit in finding a great location for anchoring. There are many things to do here, however, the key for today is to get in, anchor, and hit lime out the swimming taco bar.
We just anchored here in this Coral Bay. There's the floating taco place. We're gonna go there, get some tacos later. We got two great first mate potentials here. They wanna learn how to do the bridle.
Anywhere.
First time doing the bridle.
Can we hook it? Just like that.
When the chain is loose, stop. Is the
so
chain
relaxed, not yeah. Under tension anymore.
Yes.
With the anchor and bridle set, we got into the dinghy and started heading across the bay to lime out. Everybody wants tacos.
Cheers! Cheers, everybody! Thank you!
There we go. Michael is in, number one. What do you think, Roy, of this place?
Out.
What do you think?
Lime out, mm. Hanging out.
VFW, that means he's been drinking.
The fun continued and continued, and we were one of the last ones at the end. It was time to head back.
Okay, is the whole line in the boat, right?
Yeah. Whole line is in the boat.
I don't want it in the prom.
No.
Okay.
Woo!
You got room.
Thank you, everybody. Have a good day.
Thank you.
Don't start it, Barry. Don't have no, because you got lines underneath you.
Some of us wanted to go check out the horseback rides at the Carolina Corrals. Others wanted to check out the haunted church. But we were sitting here on the boat, hot and sweaty. Why not go swimming? Oh, that was great. But it was time to sit down and talk among each other as to what to do for dinner. We had two options. Skinny legs, but it was closed that day. And the other option was to go to Jolly Dog Bar on the Walk. Took the dinghy at night and went there, had great food, and finished yet another fantastic evening. Another gorgeous morning. Some are having coffee, some water, and look at the sign. The reason for another celebration.
Somebody's retiring.
I just
look at that.
And great breakfast
by Chef Roy, but it is time to get going.
Picking up the anchor. All right, there's Roy picking up the anchor. Michael's helping him under the direction of Anne.
Anchors away, Captain.
Okay, we can get underway. Passage plan is 8.5 nautical miles, go around Red Point. The trip should take us about a little over an hour as we go by Thread Needle Point, then we get to Leinster Point, heading into our final destination of Waterlemon Bay.
Nibbling on sponge cake, watching the sun bake, all of those tourists covered with oil, strumming my six string on my front porch swing, smell those shrimp they're beginning to boil.
Louie, you can listen to the views out
there. Wasting away.
How's the cruise going?
Awesome. It is awesome.
Dora Lynn, what do you think?
Oh my God, it's so gorgeous out here. I love it. Totally love it.
Louie, what do you think? There's Watermelon Key, that little chunk of land. We're going to go right around it to Leinster Bay and try to snag a mooring ball. Louie's there to help me.
He had the boat hook ready and grabbed me one of those 20 mooring balls. We were set in just 6 feet of water depth here in this beautiful national park. There's so much to do here with like 30 different trails that you can hike and a sugar plantation ruins that we might want to visit.
Good times.
Oh my God, this is beautiful here, guys.
This is beautiful.
Good
beautiful.
Job spotting that pay station. There's Sarah.
Another hot day, time to get in the water. This was supposed to be the number one snorkeling spot in the entire U.S.V.I. I had to go down and find out why. I had barely gone in the water and I saw this beautiful eagle-spotted ray just right underneath me passing by. I had to go up and tell the others to come down. There's beautiful stuff down here. Dora Lynn and Michael geared up and also suited up, and Roy was already in the water with me, ready to go. There's Michael scoping things around and checking out what's under. Roy and Dora Lynn also looking for things, and Barry also scouring and was intent on finding some beautiful corals. There was some here and there, not too bad. But the fish wasn't very abundant, some colorful ones here and there. At this point, I wasn't sure if I spotted a shark, a small shark, but I know Roy was seeing this beautiful turtle hanging down. I said the word stingray and everybody was out of the water. Had to go back down and check it out, see if it's really a stingray. It was kind of hiding in the sand, buried, but anyway, taking a look at it here, sure it was. So beautifully camouflaged in the sand. What a fun time in the water. Time to dry off. As Louis drying off his towel here, the girls are dancing, so it must be close to happy hour time. 5 o'clock somewhere.
having fun on this trip?
Yeah. Thanks a lot, guys. I don't know what else to say. Thank you, thank you.
Thanks.
I wish you the best. We're having the best.
We're having a good time. We got Chef Mickey and Chef Roy here in the kitchen cooking us up a dinner. And that's what we're doing. We had a good day snorkeling. You could barely see it. It's getting dark.
Sauteing some vegetables that we're going to add to our rice.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah.
So just trying to get a lot of flavors.
Look at those.
I swear, you have your own aquarium here.
Look at them! Oh my God.
Oh my
Whoever
God,
said this was God. Disneyland, it really is. It's like an adult Disneyland.
Oh my Lord.
Oh my God. You are still kicking ass.
Oh my God.
Happy birthday to you!
Oh, that's
old. We got chicken. We got fish. It is time to sit down and have a nice dinner after a little hectic fun evening. From a birthday party to a great dinner and now a retirement party. Seems like some dancing is in the works.
Departing the mooring ball.
Okay, go ahead, bring it in.
A quick passage plan today, 3.5 miles, about a half an hour. We enter between Mary Point and Whistling Key and head to Cinnamon Bay, also known as Maho Bay in some places.
Heading to Maho Bay, just left Leinster Bay. Gonna go between Mary Point and Whistling Key. It is 11:15. And we are here. Everybody's working hard to secure us to a mooring ball.
Don't play it Spanish.
What do you guys think of Francis Bay and Trunk Bay and Maho Bay?
We were actually nestled between Francis Bay and Trunk Bay. Got in a dinghy and headed towards Cinnamon Beach. And note to self, this beach has a place for trash to get picked up. And there's Francis Bay in the background. We can barely locate our boat here. Everybody landed on that beach and couldn't wait to get into that water. This bay has some of the bluest waters in the entire Caribbean. The clarity is superior. Some stayed on the beach, chased geckos, some were in the water, and some went snorkeling. And Roy had a good point here.
The corals were a lot better yesterday.
Yeah, but their colors are better here.
Well, let's take a look. Yeah, the colors look a little bit better than yesterday. Clarity is better, maybe that's why. But they're mostly destroyed. There's not as many vibrant ones. Time to head back to the boat and read some books.
On Sunday night, we're not watching football, but this man right here, he's got three burners going. The burners working. What are you doing here?
Sauteed mushrooms.
Uh-huh.
And butter.
Uh-huh.
And we've got bow tie pasta with a meat sauce for the bow ties.
Nice.
We ate good, had a round of games, and finished another beautiful night. The start of another beautiful day, and Anna's about to
cast off.
And after just a few days, the crew is clicking very nicely. Everybody's doing their job perfectly. Anna's handling the sticks magnificently. And they are now on their own.
Flemishing their lines nicely.
Should be a relatively easy day today, as we are merely relocating the vessel from one bay to another.
Saying goodbye to Cinnamon Bay, Peter Bay, and Maho Bay.
Everything is secure.
Yeah.
You guys doing okay?
Yes. Yeah.
The reason for relocating the boat is so we can be closer to Cruiz Bay.
Speeding up.
Speeding up.
Heading to Caneel Bay by Solomon's, the closest area for a mooring, so we can get to Cruiz Bay by dinghy. A 45-minute slow cruise for less than 3 nautical miles.
Approaching Hawk's Nest Bay.
Okay, and make an adjustment to course. This is Ram Goat Key. On our left is St. John's. We're gonna go right in between them. How's it going?
Very good.
How's it going?
Fine trip, fine morning.
Why? Who gives way here? He gives way, oh, he sails, so you have to give way to him, so that's a good observation. How are you guys doing?
Very good.
And here's the crew getting ready to snag a mooring ball.
We're at Caneel Bay, trying to snag a mooring ball, putting people who've never done it for exercise training. Anne's gonna take us down below and show you the details of how it's done.
Roy's holding the dinghy in place. There's the mooring ball we're going for. Louie and Dora Lynn are in position to hook it. Michael's ready with the lines. Captain Barry is up there focusing on getting that ball.
Okay, I need one person pointing their hand at it and giving me distance to it.
Okay. 12. From the end of your pole to that thing.
I got it.
Okay, bring it in.
Awesome.
Okay. Get the rope in there. Yep. You got this one?
Once.
This is Dora Lynn's first attempt ever.
And then.
Woo-hoo. Good job, everyone. Good job.
Okay, we got her.
All right.
On a mooring ball for the night. The pay station is right next to us. $26 for the night. Not a bad deal. A very busy mooring field here. Because of its proximity to Cruiz Bay. That's why it was time to get in a dinghy and head over there. A quick ride, about 20 minutes, and we were in Cruiz Bay itself.
This place is an awesome place. Wow. Oh, look at that. You missed it. She wasn't facing you, though.
No, it's all for you. You're the single man.
It was pretty good.
Look at this place.
Here she comes back.
Whether hungry or horny, it was definitely time to eat and also give Roy a break from cooking every night. Definitely felt good being on land in the evening, as we've been spending every night on the boat. Cruiz Bay is so beautiful here, you get the feeling that you don't even want to leave. However, no trip is complete without some shopping, and the ladies were itching to get on land and shop. After a quick tour of the town, and of course some shopping was done, it was time to head back to the water and find our dinghy so we can head home.
We departed Canal Bay at St. John's, and now we're heading for Magens Bay on St. Thomas.
All right, thanks for joining us on the flybridge.
Ride and doll, Cookie Bay, and Water Bay.
It's guitars, tiki bars, and a whole lot of love.
Narrow, super narrow type of palm trees that grow within the vegetation.
Our cruise today was to take an hour and 45 minutes, as we were going at a speed of 11 knots and our distance was slightly less than 12 nautical miles. We faced a little bit of a confused state of the sea here around Picara Point, but all is well and we entered the bay. We dropped anchor at 10:33 a.m. Early arrival because there's so much to do here. Ziplining, the St. Peter Estate, there's a mile-long beach. Banana Daiquiri was originated here, so it was happy hour time for many. There's guided walk tours and water tours, discovery nature trails, guided walk eco tours. Uh-oh, wait, there's Louis. I wonder what he's thinking about. Hard to leave this beach and this beautiful scenery, but when you're hungry, it's time to go. Took a truck to Burke's Bar, where Louis finally found his wallet and had dinner. We got back to the boat just in time so we can enjoy the sunset. We had some strong winds with some powerful gusts that evening. Even Louis was drying off his shirt right there in the wind. Anne and Sarah were packing, as this was our last night at sea. We were lucky to have the most beautiful sunset of our entire charter. But I think I'm hearing some music at the bow, dancing music at the bow. I wonder what the crew's up to. Wednesday, our last day at sea and our final departure. Time to say goodbye, Magens Bay.
Bye, Megan.
Look at this nice super yacht. And look at these nice, beautiful people.
Admiral.
Good notation, Roy. That was the Admiral. Back at sea, just like every day, we've had some little bit choppiness and some swells. But everybody's done well. Some had the patch on, which helped them a lot. But overall, everything went well. The passage plan for the last day is to go from Magens Bay all the way to Water Island. We were lucky when we were landing to have a video that depicted our entire leg of the last day. You could see in below all those details of all the areas that we covered. About 22 nautical miles today. Took us 3.5 hours as we were going at a speed of 9 knots to Water Island and specifically Druiff Bay. Passing Red Rock Marina here, another option on St. Thomas if we ever come here for another marina. And Water Island is in sight. Our heading is into Druiff Bay, where we had a mooring ball reserved.
One of those brown buoy that are reserved. And Louis just are tying up the two lines for the mooring ball.
Okay, good job, everyone. Got a... Okay, Louis, good job. As the oasis of the seas arrives.
With the boat's mooring all sorted out, some elected to stay on the vessel and have a little bit of a happy hour and maybe cook later. Others decided to go to dinghies on land, the beach bar and grill.
What do you think of the dinghy bar?
That was very, very, very fun.
Awesome.
Good to meet some new people.
That's true.
Yeah.
I like that. I like that.
Very, very fun.
I like that. Well, there's more fun coming.
Back on the boat, somewhere in the galley, slaving away. It is past 2 o'clock and we haven't had lunch yet. It was a little bit of a frenzy because once you're hungry and you're trying to put everything together, it was not easy. Got a lot of leftovers, but one thing we haven't done yet.
We haven't shown the cabins yet. Let's see one cabin. They're all the same. Listen,
Linda. Oh, what a mess. Oh, yeah. Everything is here. Cooking away while the sister is floating away.
Well, it is after 3 o'clock in the afternoon and time to leave the fun behind and head back to home port. Our final approach goes through a tight little slot, takes us back to Charlotte Amalie. After the safe return, that night we did what was always expected every night. We danced the night away.